So what does a press pot look like? It's nothing more than a beaker, glass beaker. You can get them in they're available in stainless steel as well. This one's got all my coffee grounds in it from after making the coffee. Here's what the, let me rinse this off. If there is a negative for using a French press, what I just did there is part of it. You get grounds on this that need to be washed off and in the sink. And then you've got all these grounds inside here that have to be rinsed out. Wah, my first world problems. I've got grounds that I have to clean up. Oh, yeah, I know. But I don't like it much either. So I don't use a press pot much. I do sometimes, but not much. When I'm on the road in this upcoming trip to Tuktoyaktuk in Northwest Territories in Canada, which I'm leaving in several days. What was I talking about? Oh, I have a traveling French press that Derek got me. This is cool. Okay. This is cool. Oh yeah, this traveling French press is cool. Cylinder, stainless steel, nice. It's made by Stanley. God damn it. What is the malfucking function here? I'm pretty sure that malfunction is not going to make the video. You might see that over in the outtakes department. Okay, so you've got this Stanley. It is stainless steel. It looks to be about 16 ounces. Let's see if it says.
Let me get on my granny glasses, eh? How big is she?
Well, she's 16 ounces, 473 milliliters for all you knuckleheads that live in Canada. I love Canada. I've always loved Canada. Excepting for those times when they wouldn't let me in their country. Or they accused me of smuggling. Okay, so you got this gizmo. You got this thing. Stainless steel, you got this thing, which this is actually the same thing as this. Press, this thing. So you put your grounds in. You set this in, let it set for a few minutes. You then press it. And then you screw on this lid. And it's got a thermos type lid to it. You can hook it onto your belt loop. But the reality is now this sits in your cup holder in your car. It's just the right size. Voila. So while on this Arctic Ocean trip that I'll be taking in just a few days, this is what I'll be drinking pretty much all of my coffee. I've got this stainless steel mug that I know is in my kitchen bin. I'll use that sometimes when I'm on camp, but when I'm traveling, I'm gonna use this. So, I like kettles. I like copper kettles. Copper kettles are best. Why? It's quite easy. Because I like them. Grind your coffee very coarsely. Now, if you're using a grinder, shame on you. If you're using a grinder that has two blades, if you open the top and you see blades in there, that is not a grinder. That is a nut chopper. And back in the 70s, that's what they were called, choppers. Some guy in China said, oh, let's call these coffee grinders. Is that racist? Is that racist talking like that? Oh, you cannot grind coffee like that. You. Yeah, no, that's racist as fuck. Okay, what you do is, no. What was I talking about? The grinder. If you've got blades in your grinder, that's not a coffee grinder. That's a chopper. That's slicing the coffee. You end up with powder. You end up shake and then crunch on top. And the water is not able to evenly distribute that diffusion of wonderfulness in the coffee. Throw that thing away or use it for nuts or herbs and spices only. You need a coffee grinder. It is a burr grinder. B-U-R-R. That's a type, not a name, not a brand name. What that is, it's grinding the coffee so the particulate is all the same size, plus minus, but it's all the same size. Excuse me. So the extraction is perfectly even. So if you've got a nut chopper, remember, if you've got a nut chopper, get rid of it. Don't use it for coffee. I've told people many times, if you go out and buy a good grinder, and you don't have to spend a lot of money, burr grinders are not that expensive, it will change your life. If you're pre-grinding your coffee in the morning, especially if you're not, if you're buying ground coffee, and I can convince you to purchase a good burr grinder and grinding your beans right before you use it, it will change your life. And I've told people, if I'm lying, you bring that grinder to me and I will pay you every penny that you paid for it. It's never happened. And I've had many people come back to me and say, Jesus Christ, I can't believe I've been... Well, they didn't say Jesus Christ. They may have said Jesus Christ, but if they didn't say Jesus Christ, they said at least, at the very least, at the bare minimum, they said, wow, what a difference that made. Or if they're really stoic, they would have said, wow, that was awesome. Right? Okay. So that's it for the French press. You got to make water hot. You got to have a press. You let the water and the coffee sit in there about 4 minutes before you press it. That's it. There's nothing to it. And what is the value in doing a cup of coffee in a French press? It's stronger. It's got more oomph. Really, what's happening is there's more particulate in the coffee, so it gives it more body. It's delicious. It's freaking awesome. Do I do it a lot? No, I don't, because basically I'm a lazy slob and I want my coffee fast. Okay, that's a thing. But maybe if I have a guest and she says, I'd like a cup of coffee. I said, oh, brother, I'll make you a cup of coffee. You know, then I make a big deal about putting it all on a press and making it happen. She goes, oh, oh my gosh, that's so good. Oh, you were such a good man. That's happened. I swear, well, I'm not going to swear, but it probably happened something like that where it happened. It could have happened. And then again, sometimes I take them out and get lattes. Oh, back when I had my espresso machine, I don't do that anymore because it broke. I don't make much espresso anymore. I'd make lattes. Oh. Now, that's a panty dropper. You make a woman a mocha in the morning. She's got you on the short list. That's a man who'll make me a mocha in the morning. Yes. Trust me, guys. Christopher Evans knows. I've been around the block a few times. I've been to a few county fairs in my life. Trust me. Know how to make your gal a good cup of coffee in the morning. Make it for her every day. Start the day off right. As long as she's willing to make you sandwiches whenever you want them, you ought to make her a goddamn cup of coffee in the morning. That's it. We're done here.